Again, it is important to add that when the elves set their minds to things, they really follow through. So when they realized that the faster the bike pedaled, the more fog was made, they decided to make enough fog to fill the entire North Pole and the world. They pedaled and pedaled and pedaled, one on the left pedal and one on the right pedal. They jumped up and down on the pedals, making Santa's fog bike go faster and faster and faster and faster and faster. They pedaled this bike so fast that you could no longer see them, in part because they were going very fast, and in part because they created so much fog that you couldn't even see your hand if you held it in front of you. Santa woke from his regular nap and set to getting dressed in his official Christmas suit, red pants, coat, hat, and black boots. He brushed out his white beard and, with the help of Mrs. Claus, his wife, combed down his white beard hair. Excited for the evening ahead, Santa stepped out in the Christmas Eve night. As he walked outside, he realized he couldn't see his sleigh. He couldn't see his reindeer. He couldn't see anything. He whistled to his reindeer, "On Dasher, on Dancer, on Prancer, on Vixen, Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen, where are you?" "Here we are, Santa, ready for a foggy night ahead," they shouted together. As they tried to take off, however, none of the reindeer could see where they were going. "Oh dear, we will crash into houses at this point," shouted Santa. Just then, he could hear the group of penguins talking. "My pictures aren't turning out in this weather," shouted one penguin. "Mine either," shouted the other one. Then Santa remembered the penguin's conversation about the little reindeer with the red nose. Santa called out, "Rudolph, Rudolph." In the distance flickered a red bright light, brighter than anything you could have seen. "Yes, Santa," said Rudolph. "The elves, the snowmen, the penguins, Mrs. Claus and her relatives, all of the reindeer gasped in delight." Santa smiled and said, "Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight?" Rudolph was placed at the head of the sleigh, filled with happiness. His nose was important. He was important. He began to love and grow even happier as the reindeer behind him began to cheer. They lifted him high into the sky with the brightness and redness from Rudolph's nose, guiding them on their way. "Ho, ho, ho," exclaimed Santa. "Yippee," cheered the reindeer. When they turned home after a great Christmas Eve of delivering presents, all the reindeer began to open their own presents given to them from Santa. In Rudolph's presence was a very own Monopoly game. It was signed "Love, Santa." And the reindeer, he now knew that all those at the North Pole accepted him. Every day, Rudolph played with the other reindeer, feeling their love since he could guide them through the hide and seek. Even if it ever got stormy or if the elves ever got hold of Santa's newly made fog bikes, which they often did. Because of his beautiful nose, all the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee, "Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, you'll go down in history!"